Hey, what I'm gonna do today and the next couple of days is transforming a white conference room wall into a whiteboard with specific colors. Prepare it in a way that you can write on it with a whiteboard marker and wipe it away, I hope. Okay, this is what we're going to use. This is first of all the transparent preparation for the painted walls, and this is the whiteboard color. It's a two component polyurethane, I think, color. You have to mix that, but that's tomorrow. Today is preparation, and this preparation, I bought this frog tape. It's said to be very precise at the lines. We'll see. Never used it before. We'll see. So this is it. This is the conference room wall, white. It's gonna be a whiteboard wall. It's 8.5 meters wide, and the whiteboard area will be 1.5 meters high. So in total, it'll be more or less 10 square meters of whiteboard area. Pretty cool. So I'm using this board as a meter. I marked 1.5 meters here and zero there, and I'll go from mark to mark to get my 1.5 meter height marked on the wall. Okay, this is it for the preparation. I marked the area. I got a little, like not little, but a stronger foil on the ground. And I taped one of those painter foils. Just unfolded it two times and then taped it underneath the area. And where I'm going to paint, I'll draw this cardboard with me, and the blue one goes a little up the wall. I don't know how liquid this whole thing is going to be. For sure the preparation I'm doing today is pretty liquid, so morning. This is second day of the whiteboard project, and this is behind me the perfectly dry grounding base color, whatever you call it. Okay, this is what we're gonna do now. Now we mix the two components, 2 minutes mechanically preferred, will do. And we have the roller and the, what do you call that blue thing? I don't know, but you know what it is. And so we do our first layer of the whiteboard. erster Anstrich. Super, super. Sieht man jetzt noch nichts, aber es ist, hat nicht viel getropft. Es war echt gut zu streichen. Okay, good morning. So this is dried overnight, and for today I bought myself a mask. It was pretty heavy breathing and smelled awfully yesterday, so I considered a mask is be good, would be good. And since I'm going to grind with the 220 paper this morning a little bit, I use it too. Of course, you don't have to have that powder in your lung. So, let's get started. Day two, it's polished, grinded, add another layer of color. Tomorrow I'll grind again and add the last layer of color. Then 10 days of drying, and now let's get out of here.
Yo, this is Jesse. Let's get cooking again.
It's me, just me. I'm just starting my last day on this project. Start grinding off with the 220 paper again, and then do the last final layer of color. Not grinding that afterwards, and then 10 days, no touching, no using, waiting. Yeah.